So, following along from the mesh light rework from yesterday, where I changed up how like the import data is kind of brought in, the naming scheme and what have you, for both this and armatures, to bring about this. Now what I want to do is modify, not for armatures anyways, but for meshes. I want to have the ability to, let's say, generate a cube. So instead of importing mesh data from a file, we can generate a cube, or otherwise generate a ico-sphere, I think I also have. Yes. Like that. With int recursion being whatever. So we can import either from this or from one of these other types. So one of the first things I'm probably going to have to do is let's go back to meshes, shall we? There's a lot of nonsense going on in here. All right. So what I'm going to say is this is the one where we have the mesh import data. Or rather, let's delegate it down actually to an internal. From file where we have this mesh data, mesh import data. Where we basically put all this stuff. Basically, almost all of this goes into that, wouldn't it? For the moment, let's just put it all in there. Come true. We change this up to if null pointer return false, otherwise return if pmesh data. Cast of this type. MP file import not equal null pointer. Then we go into this function. We go to this. Okay, and then we make sure that's const as well, right? We're not accidentally modifying it. Can I do a const? Can I just like convert it straight to a const? Or not. Let's see how this works. No, that works. So it's a const type. And then we also have the same for the others. So if almost the same thing, if auto const blah 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 blah. P generate cube. Generate ico-sphere. Then we go in and do something else. And then same thing again for generate sphere. Where we need a common base class, base type. That actually need all of that. That and that. Change that. Does this work? Doesn't quite look like it. Why? Mesh data source is not polymorphic. Are you sure? Oh. Does it need to be like virtual? Is this what I really need? I need something like this. Not quite, I guess. Okay. We're just going to do it a different way, where we will always be p next equals do, 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 do. We'll just change this to be like a void star. Okay. Oh God. Yeah, this is not. Wait. This does have a p next, though, right? There we go. I can still do this. Right. Oh, is it because it, okay, no, this can work. Okay, then we can do this mesh import from file. Generate cube. Which will be somewhat similar, I think. Generate a cube, please. How does one cube? Okay. Basically no point in this one, but I'll bring it in anyways. Source data. I guess. So we need a float that's of, okay, first of all, actually we want this components. Okay, we got a cube. Generated that. So then we're going to grab the actual data. We'll make it a, I guess, number of indices, which is fine and dandy. Model index data 16, I guess. Offset of 0. No, it definitely has export stuff. Don't know what exactly you're going on about. Then, actually split this right again. Come on, proof of concept stuff is always wrecking my mind. Okay, we got the stuff we need, them vertices. Next data, there's no weights, no nothing like that. We need this. Staging buffer and stuff. Which we might need. Okay, vertex data size, that's how we get that. Index data size. Equals this. You know what? It doesn't really matter, one way or the other. I gotta do a multiply our times. I'd rather do it this way. Vertex data size, index data size, we're going with a 16 type instead. Vertex data size again. Wait, hold on. Which one is that one? Bone offset. 0. We don't have any. Okay. If there are code. Have a couple of vcareses here, yes. Around. As I go move through, I'm slowly refining each time this process. Well, that's how I'm going to tell myself, anyways. Data size, staging buffer, staging allocation, if we need them. Otherwise, we do this, we map the model buffer, copy any data in. We don't have vertex weight data size this time. Unmap. Go through this process. Upload data. We don't have that this time. And then again, this is index data size. No mesh bones, there's no per vertex weights. Mm-hmm. Return true. Now let's see if this will even work. Shall we? So then we're gonna generate cube. That instead. Let us see. So do applications, go down here. Star P. Find or create, and it's just like test cube. I mean, I know at most, in reality, you'll probably only generate like one or maybe two cubes via code, but the idea here is primarily so that I can actually run through the process again, expand upon it, iterate upon it, make it a little bit better in preparation for more expansive. I want something that's more fairly modular, something I can easily update in the future. Which is like one of the worst design goals to ever have, I'm pretty sure. But, yeah, whatever. Generate cube. Cannot initialize with an R value of type that. Really. What? What? Okay, very nice. Okay. Ah, yes, I'm on the wrong thing. It's not an armature, it's a freaking mesh. That makes a lot more sense. Okay. So then we go in for that, and then we see what goes on, shall we? Undefined reference to these guys. Why? For model cube vertex data. Is like cube, not even like it's there. Am I missing something? No. It's not being that. Yeah, it's got regular attributes. I mean, I got everything else out of this. If I model cube that. It's got that. What's the difference? Foam model cube. Yeah, it's all there. Vertex component. Foam model export. It's great. Better not be that, because that'd be so weird. That'd be really weird. Okay, good. It's not that. Libs model C build and then libs model lib whatever dot so grep q dash iq. What we got That. What were we missing, friend? Sorry. Foe model cube number vertices. Okay. It's not in the anonymous namespace. It's outside of it for sure. Is it because? No. They're the same signature int that. And he's brought in. He's defined. What is go? Okay. Is it something like even weirder? Like, hold on. No, I'm bringing it in directly. Here's the linker thing, right? So it's all this. Come on, let me freaking highlight. Let me close enough. What is going on? So linking these objects with all these libraries. Yep. Right there. I have no clue what is going on here with just specifically this cube thing. Why just this? Foe model export, yeah. This vertex data, num indices, and that. Like, why? Okay, and then if I were to go in here and say, "Hey, I'd like a test cube, please." Wait a second. It's I have this inside the anonymous namespace. All the declarations are also anonymous, right? Oh my. Of course. You idiot. Okay, well, one quick thing I can do. The cube, I like this added exp. Yes. Oh, almost. Undo. 2/20/21. Right, I do have a 2/20/21, right? It goes that way. Sure, it does now. What was I doing? I was testing loading of these guys. Yes. Close you. Go to here. Yes, test cube does not exist. So that's that, that, and then we have this one, which goes in. Fantastic. It's a null pointer, so it goes to generate cube, then it goes into that and does that one instead. Very nice. And then if we were to, so right now, the thing that's loaded up is coming through is this. Self curl. Which is actually impressive. Test cube. It becomes false. It becomes test cube. It's not boned, no animation. Just the cube, right? Just the cube. Neat. And let's see if we can do the same thing for a sphere, and then we try to figure out how to abstract away this graphics upload process to something where we don't really. Yeah. Pretty much the same as this from this point on. And the first part is going to be quite similar to this stage up here, except for the ico-sphere import header, generation header. Okay, I should have probably actually fixed that up or squashed it into the last one as well. Model generator headers. Back to this. So instead of this, it'll be for, where was, oh, come on. I just did it and I already lost the header. Give it to me. like that. That's great, null. Give the ico-sphere vertex data. That's great. Same thing here. Num indices. Index data. I'm not sure why I'm not actually getting this stuff. Just a bit of a header thing. Foe model icosphere num vertices. It says what? Requires recursion. Ah, yes. See if we can do the same thing in application, but instead it's to generate test sphere. Sphere. Generate icosphere. That with a pointer to recursion. Come on, come on. PMesh be next. Recursion equals two. Now that was a bit of fun. Let's go up here. Let's see if we got a test icosphere to go. Yes, we do. Okay. So still a standard unique pointer. So we don't actually need anything here. Because we only have one. Right? And that's not going to screw anything up. Right? I just need to default that. Okay. Okay, where we set this stuff is like way up here somewhere. Yeah. Okay, we don't also don't need to actually have this in here. Stuff, do we? No. Put this here. I wish I could like new something. Without having to make constructors. Like a designated initializer on a new object. That's a dream. Okay, so this basically becomes new mesh import data. Don't really need any of the rest of this stuff. Sorry, no, it's int recursion. Pass all that all the way through. Meshes. Into recursion. Change that up a little bit. So it's from file. Okay, and it's a recursion of 1 in this case. So don't actually have to have these things publicly available. They can kind of sit in the back. Okay, what kind of objects do I really have here? What is this? Is this something I really want to have publicly available? Or do I want to put it behind something? So what do I bring out? I basically bring out this stuff. I'm looking at this stuff almost all of the time. Right? But that's basically it. Mesh this, right? The graphics data, the bones, and this. I don't really need this here either because I can just unload it from mesh this, so I don't actually need this anymore really. Sorry, not here. Meshes that. So don't even really need it here. Wait, hold on. Wait, what? Okay, whatever the hell I was doing here. Otherwise, okay, this should also be like. It should be nullified. What else? That's cleared. Graphics data is nullified. Graphics, this is cleared. These are also destroyed. this stuff. Okay. Now, I'm pretty sure two these two things can actually be moved to like the graphics component, really, because this is kind of separate from that. Probably later, though. So how do we actually destroy everything on the way out, Meshes? Probably should make a validation run to see if I'm actually properly deleting everything as well while I'm here. Ooh, not good. What am I doing? Destroy graphics mesh. Where is this happening? Oh, yeah, like, I'm not deleting this stuff way too... Yeah. Right. Oh, yes, don't unload, just delete from here. This is what takes care of the unloading, right? Right here. Okay. Let's see what validation says. Probably nothing good. Nothing bad. Impressive. Okay. Do I really need this here? Do I need any of this here? Or can I just maybe return? I'm just not a fan of having this stuff public. Just. Okay. Let's switch tracks for a moment while I kind of ruminate on this. The upload procedure is a little much right now. Don't really want to add more stuff. Dang it, I don't really know. Okay, I'll leave it here, having done basically a little bit of a rework. And that's about it. Privatizing some things. Taking some things out of that, adding this stuff. All right, cheers.